All right, what's up guys? So right here we have the rear quarter panel. It's all measured out. So with this, let me actually turn on the light for you guys. There we go. Let's bring this up just a little bit. So knowing this, they have a curve up here. So you want to adjust it with that curve. And right here is the trim piece. Right, you guys can't really see it. But basically what we did is, or what we're going to be doing is we're going to lay this down right here. We're gonna leave this as, I guess the term is, relaxed as possible. And then from there, I'm just gonna move forward with wrapping this front piece. And just get all this out of the way. So I did have excess, just in case there's any issues. So right here, you follow this body line, make sure everything's good. All right. And then, let's see here, back here. I would trim it, but in today's, tutorial. All right, I don't know if I could call it a tutorial, but yeah, we're not going to do that. Just gonna make sure dust is all out of the way. We are in an airport area, so dust is always an issue, but it's always a fun challenge. So let's get started. So today we're using Avery. Gently. That down. Okay. That. Right here. Tack that right. Tack that. Different case. Me about how I'm working with this. There are many different ways to doing this. There's no right or wrong way. The only wrong way that you're doing is if you're not applying enough pressure into the film and you're not overlapping, you're squeegeeing. So as you can see, I'm just working with the material. All right. No need for massive pressure. I'm seeing the film going this way, so I'm pulling towards that way. All right. Like I said, no need for rushing. That out. So typically, well, today is technically the first day of this car. The reason why I say technically is because last night the owner actually dropped this off for us. So today's Monday after Thanksgiving. All right. towards up here. I'm not using a squeegee because with all the intricate curves, I'm just gonna slowly address it all. Right now it's California. There's no such thing as winter, but it is a little cold today. So I don't believe the temperature is the right temperature exactly. See you guys how I'm doing it. I'm not stretching the material. I'm letting it work its way in to the increase or the creases right here. All right. And then you just slowly work your way up. There's no stretching. I'm not putting a lot of pressure into it. All right, I'm just gonna let this fast forward. So towards here, I'm noticing a little bit of wrinkle, so that was like my error. Not a big deal. Just grab a heat gun. And you're not heating it to the point where it's softening. You're basically restoring the wrinkle on that. So I typically use like the second to the lowest setting on here. There we go. The heat setting. Basically just relaxing the film. There we go. Just gonna make sure everything's good. Cool. And let's finish this off. So, do that. And the top is done. We're gonna address this little situation right now. I'm gonna lift this off from the trim. I'm gonna tuck it right in because we're actually gonna cut in here to make sure it's all trimmed correctly. Towards up here, I'll actually show you guys how to get that in as well. Super simple, see? I'll give you guys a close-up of this. No air bubbles, no wrinkles, nothing. All right, now we're gonna work our way down. Oh, and before I continue, always change your felt. It actually, I learned it the hard way. Because the reason why, you don't want to have a used felt every time you work on a car. You'll risk into a lot of issues. All right, I'm releasing the bottom. That out. So right here, I already introduced stretch. So I'll actually show you guys how to take care of that. Right here, let's actually take care of this first. There we go. Make sure that's in. There we go. So I may have accidentally introduced stress right here. No big deal. Level two. And basically just heating this up so that it shrinks back to the original, just like that. All right, cool. All right. Make sure there's no air bubbles. I'm not gonna squeeze you to the side yet because it's very tempting, but you don't need to do that yet. I'll take care of that. All right, cool. So now towards this little angle right here, we're gonna do a little, something a little different. Since this is a mat, we're gonna heat this up just a little bit. I'm gonna pull, and I'm gonna hook right under. I'm gonna heat it up just so I can pulse heat it. Or I can shift it back together. And there we go. That's the first corner. Just make sure that it's working. Hit it again. And if it's not going anywhere, then you're doing a good job. That's my phone. Cool. And same thing with all the other corners, which I'll show you guys. It's actually working on this corner right here. There's a lot of excess. We're gonna get rid of it. All right, cool. Heat this up just a little bit. Let's bring it up just a little bit. Heat up just a little bit and pull it right in. Heat it up again just to make sure that it stays. And there we go. Another perfect corner. There we go. I'm gonna address these. So I'm not applying a lot of heat into this because I'm just basically pushing all this in. Right there. Same thing here. Cool. All right, next we're gonna tackle this corner. So with this open, I'm not gonna cut into the paint. So I'm doing that. Best way is you basically cut like that. Be careful not to release anything. All right, now to address this little corner right here, I'm gonna bring it up, I'm gonna pull it, I'm gonna hook it right under. for the purpose of this demonstration, let's see here. I think I'm gonna cut instead. So what I'll do is I'll trim this off so I can have that perfect little crease. Alright, being careful not to cut too. Alright, so right now, right here, there we go. Make sure everything's straightened out. Cool. So I'm leaving a gap right here, but I'm gonna cut along the trunk. All right. Getting close to that. And I'm gonna, and right there, I'm not gonna cut anymore. Up here, I'm gonna pull it up just a little bit. Get rid of that. This one comes off. And right here, lift this side up. Cut. That way you have something to play with when you are tucking or doing your corners. Now, open this up. And lift this up. A little bit of a stretch. Okay. Heat it up. So in the case where it's not hugging into the corner, you want to bring it out just a little more and heat it up. And there we go. That looks good. And then from there, you stuck in the rest. Heat it one more time just to make sure it's in. There we go. Alright, now I'm going to take care of all this. Let's bring down the fan speed. Here's the fun part. So, I'm gonna leave that there. I'm basically cutting along the chrome piece, but I'm not applying as much pressure into it. Because a lot of pressure means no. All right, from there, take that off. And get to this little corner, cut that off. Slow and gentle. All right, let's finish off this little corner right here. Heat it up just a little bit. Lift this up and pull. There we go. And then from there, you can finish it off. There you go. It's coming out really nice. You guys can kind of already see the difference between the two colors. All right, cool. Now, no need to worry about this. I'm gonna full send this all the way down. So slowly. Bring this down. Make sure it's glassed out. Down here is a lot more prone to dust, which gets pretty annoying. So I'm actually going to bring that to there. There we go. Make sure that's wrapped in. And then pull down. So now for this, I'm actually going to full send it all the way, like I said earlier. This, a lot of static. Remove that. Take that out just a little bit. Give it a good pull. There we go. You can adjust the bottom side first. Dress up here now. Just do by hand. There's no need to use a squeegee at this point right here. In case any of you guys are wondering, yes, the floor is clean. I did a full cleanup before I even bothered getting on the ground, because this floor does get pretty filthy. Cool. And now we're gonna address trimming all this down. Alright, so let's take care of this first. So I'm not cutting up here, I'm leaving that there for now. Towards that door, you gotta be really careful. Alright, cool. I'm letting the blade glide, I'm not putting any pressure into it. And there, that's the bottom piece. Now, coming towards here, you gotta be really careful because you haven't cut this piece yet. So, we're gonna lift this up just a little bit. I'm gonna cut it outwards. Careful not to cut the paint. And cool. Now I can open this door. Take care of this little corner right here. I did a little cold stretch right there. And I'm gonna heat it up just to see if it's going to cause any problems. And it looks like it's good. All right, cool. I can cut it. Let's bring that down just a little bit. Grab my squeegee. Alright. Cool, that's out of the way. Tuck it in. That's in all the way too. All right. Bring this up. Making sure that's good. One thing worth noting, because this one has like the plastic weather strip, you wanna grab a tool. I typically use one of these, this little red thing. lift it up just a little bit so that you can tuck it right in. I can start from here. There we go. You guys can't see it, so I'm sorry. That's done. So I'm heating this up relatively a lot so I can push it in. Still on low temperature setting. It's just blowing a lot. Is beautiful. Now, I'm not cutting into the paint, but I'm just going to score the excess piece. There we go. You don't need that. Damn, that looks good. And my light ledge. Here. Got that done. I can cut this off. Alright, last but not least, we're gonna address the bottom piece. It's all going to be tucked inside, or right by the plastic piece in here. And when you guys are wrapping a Tesla, you guys will know what I'm talking about. So, relief cut right here. Actually, you know what? I might as well just cut it right here. There we go. really straightforward. Just run the knife in and it just glides right through. Excess, I'm just gonna get rid of. Cool. Done. And basically, it's all in there. Last piece of the puzzle. Oh, this is the hard stuff, actually. All right. Same ordeal. Hook it in, and then you cut it. There we go. All right, last thing we're gonna do, I'm gonna adjust this little guy right here. So this is already tucked in. Let me just go and check to make sure that it's in, and that's good. So I'm gonna leave about a quarter of an inch for this guy. And I use my index finger for measurement. Might work for some of you guys, might not work for everyone. Just as you guys can see, I'm going pretty slow. There's no need to rush it. There we go. And down here, same deal. Keep it about a quarter of an inch. There we go. Look at that. And now for the tucking. So before you guys do this, make sure, before you guys even lay this down, you guys gotta make sure under here, behind here, it's all clean from all dust. Because it happens. I've had it happen to me a couple times where it's not clean and I just wrap right under it and it didn't stick. So what I'm doing right now is I'm slowly wrapping right behind it and I'm applying heat. It's kind of like fender rolling. If you guys have heard of that before, you heat up the panel and you just tuck it right in. All right. make sure everything's in. Cool. And so it's right here. I have a lot of excess in here. So be your own judgment. Cut out what you don't need. There we go. Keep that up one more time. I'm gonna take care of this guy right here. So this little corner right there, I heated up this a little bit so I can push it in. There we go. And here, just heat it up and guide it in. Keep this up just a little bit more. I'm gonna tuck this side in. Alright. Now, because we don't need that much, I'm just gonna cut right here. Inwards. Alright, I'm gonna release this. There we go. Now to finish this top piece off, make sure that corner's good. And ta-da, we finished. Woo! Just gonna heat this up, all these corners up, just to make sure that it's not going anywhere. And there we go. All right, thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys later.